Hey guys, welcome back to an episode of the Matt Light podcast. I am Dustin. Who am I?
You're Matthew Light.
I'm Matthew Light. That's the Matt Light podcast. And alongside me here is Dustin Dowling. Matthew. Dustin, that's the first time that I aimed the right direction.
I was waiting. I was wondering if you were going to wait for me to pull it up again because you forget each time.
No, I got it, man.
You got it. Way to go. Congratulations.
Thanks for being on my show again.
Yeah. Thanks for having me, by the way. I really appreciate that.
We have like a little Tom Green vibe here. Remember when he had people in the back? It was his buddy Phil would just sit there and drink coffee.
Yeah, and do nothing. Yeah.
That's great.
I think I do a lot for the show.
Not really.
Yeah. I feel like I'm doing a lot.
Honestly, he does everything. I just show up. You're like, Matt, are you hungover? I'm like, yeah. You're like, well, you're 3 hours late. I'm like, I know.
You took me to lunch. I appreciate that.
I always take you to lunch.
Yeah. That's basically enough for me. And I'm like, whatever you want. You want a whole studio for 5 hours? Cool.
Yeah.
Cool. Primani sandwich?
Yeah.
All day.
Deal.
I got you. Yeah, deal.
Why do people not like Primani's?
I don't get it. They just want to be anti-Pittsburgh because they think it's cool.
Yeah. Like, I'll be honest, the Pittsburgher is not the best.
Yeah.
But, like, why would you order that?
Yeah, there's a lot of sandwiches, and let's be honest, the pastrami is the best.
Do you know what the number one seller is? Because they say the Pittsburgh is the number two seller.
They say it's the cheesesteak, isn't
no.
it?
No.
It's not?
It's Iron City Beer.
Oh. that's the actual, what's the number one sandwich, though?
The Pittsburgher, but it says the number two seller next to it.
That's funny.
So that when you ask them, what is it, it's boom. Iron City Beer.
Iron City. 81 Days Irons.
Hey, they used to sponsor me, cuz.
I know.
Not
we need
no
to get
more.
That back. We'll get them back.
Back when we used to tailgate. It's fun. We'll be back.
Pre-pandemic.
I don't know if I can drink ever again.
That's a lie. We just had beers. We literally just had some beers less than an hour ago.
No, we drove scooters. We don't drink in scooters.
Well, we didn't drink the limit. We were under the I don't know what the scooter limit is, but I don't think it's the same as cars. I think it's way
higher.
You
think it would be the opposite because it requires hand-eye coordination, balance.
I'm not going to lie. I'm pretty comfortable behind a car, maybe with a few drinks.
It was hard.
Half a drink behind that spin thing. I'm a little nervous. You're flying ahead of me.
I maxed it out at 15 miles an hour.
Is that how fast they go?
That's how fast they go. When you first start, they give you a test.
Oh, yeah. It's
fine. And it's so funny because like I failed the test 6 times and it's the same 5 questions. I'm like, no, there's no way this is true. And they'd be like, no. And it would turn up red. You can't drive. I'm like, God damn it. Change your answers. And I just kept failing it.
Yeah, you're like my daughter who doesn't really, when she's on her phone.
You don't read.
She doesn't read. She's like, no. What's the next continue button? It's whatever that is the right answer. I'm like, what'd you click on?
Yeah.
She doesn't even know. It's like she could be accepting everything and anything.
I got my first night of sleep last night in about a week.
You having trouble sleeping? You getting old? What's the deal?
Oh, God.
You just getting old?
Partying.
Oh, you're one of those people.
My stomach hurts really bad. I went with my uncle Bill. We went to Detroit over the week. He went up to, I guess, business meetings and stuff. I don't know.
Fake business.
We were at the casino. Exactly. And I lost $900 in 8 minutes playing blackjack. I was playing $75 a hand. I got 2 twos against a 6, split them. Then I get an 11, got a double down, right?
Yeah, I guess, yeah.
Now I have 15. That's fucked. The next one I get, another 2 comes up, split that. Anyways, there's $525 invested in one hand. I have like 5 hands. None of them exceed a 16. He flips over a 5. He's got 11. Boom. 10. Jack, blackjack. Suck it, Matt.
Jack Black.
So, yeah, I lost, and I was just miserable. And the first night, I got my uncle so drunk. So drunk that he ruined my perfect Uber score.
1 second. Is that coming in? I'm sorry. That's in my studio.
That beep is in your studio.
That's in the control room. What to deal with it? It'll go away in a little bit.
Okay.
Sorry.
Great. Let's just listen to it for a minute. Hold on.
Okay. Let's take it in.
That's what my heart feels like after drinking for so long.
Oh, that's actually what it is. We have you hooked up.
Is that what it is?
Yeah, it's our official heart rate.
Perfect.
That we got for you.
No, it was crazy. I ended up getting my uncle so drunk that he puked all over the Uber. I'm now a 4.99 star. I had to pay a $25 cleaning fee for him. He could not walk. And he woke up naked in the bed next to me, not the same bed as me, but next to me. And there's no way to prepare for that. To see your uncle's dick.
Wait. It went, how'd the dick come out all of a sudden?
Well, I opened my eye. So when I went to bed, he was just shirtless, hugging the toilet.
Okay.
And at that point, I was like, good for you. Fuck off. I'm going to sleep. I wake up. There's uncle's junk just there. And I didn't know if I should cover him because I didn't want to get close to him. I didn't want to pee on me like a dog does. So I went like this. I went, smacked his forehead. I go, cover your shit, get up. And then I was at the point where I didn't even want to hang out with him the next day. Because I didn't want to get him drunk again. I was like, I'm going to the Tigers game. I'm going to the game by myself. Have fun with your work buddies. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. I don't even want to deal with it. Then he's like, oh, you can win money at the casino. I go, oh, you're right. And then I lost $1,000.
And like that $1,000.
So then I got one night of sleep. And then I had to wake up 6:30 to go to my first ever real college football game. Have you ever been to one?
Yeah, it's been a long time.
Which game?
I went to a Purdue game a long time ago.
Against?
I don't remember who they played against. I just know it was wild.
But was at Purdue?
It was at Purdue, yeah.
So it was real, like a real college atmosphere.
Yeah, parking in someone's yard. I was at another fraternity's house.
Yeah.
And then the long walk there. Like, it's just crowds everywhere. Okay. Just crowds of young, drunk people everywhere.
So I've never done it before, right? Mm-hmm. The first one that I ever do. I'm like, I got to do it right, okay? So shout out to the Bakers for hosting me. They said, well, do you want to go to the whiteout game? And I go, what is that? And Brett goes, YouTube it, and you'll see what it is. And so what it is, it's 110,000 people that wear all white. They got matching pom-poms, they matching celebrations. I'm like, oh, this is going to be so cool. This will be fun. She goes, oh, yeah, and you guys will have so much fun tailgating. I'm thinking the game's at 1:00, right? Mm-hmm. I'm like, all right, we'll get there at like 10:00. We'll have a few drinks. I find out the night before it's a 7:30 game. So I tailgate.
7:30 in the morning.
Listen, man.
Wait, 7:30 in the morning or at night?
7:30 at night.
Okay, right.
I got at Beaver Stadium at 10 a.m. Now I've
so you're on time then, right?
Listen, I've tailgated hard in my life, right? I've had a lot of fun tailgating in my life. This was insane. They had a bar at their tailgate. They had breakfast, lunch, and dinner, pretty much cooked and catered in those silver platter things. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. You know what I mean? I brought my shot wheel. I was like, oh, this will be cool. We did 30 of those. Here's the thing. I'm one of the younger ones at this tailgate. I drink pretty well. I think I do well.
Younger ones at the college tailgate. It's like a major alumni
thing?
This
is like a family thing.
Oh, okay. It's a
family.
This
is the family tailgate, right?
Family tailgate.
Here's how good our tailgate was, though. That all the college students that thought they were crazy turning up couldn't hang with us. They came over to do shots with us. I was carding them, by the way. Oh, it was so much fun. Somebody came up to me and she's like, I'll have a beer. I go, who? I was like, who are you? Right? I was like, give me your ID. And it said Portland, Maine. And I go, why the fuck would you go to Penn State, Portland, Maine? I go, who's your hockey team? She goes, I don't know. I took her ID. I go, get the fuck out of here. And just frisbee through it. I go, it's not real. You know how I knew it wasn't real? After I did that, she goes, okay.
Yeah, there was no pushback.
You would never argue it.
Yeah.
Like, how would I know what a Maine ID looks like? I just wasn't letting them drink. Mm-hmm. They could have been 35. I'm like, no, you're not old enough. I don't want you to enjoy yourself like I am.
You just like being in charge.
I like being Charles in charge. 30 shots though, dude. I had literally 30 shots. I wasn't blackout drunk. There's just something about playing the dizzy bat, doing the cornhole, the flip cup, the music. It's just.
You're getting better. You're just getting better at everything.
I'm a seasoned veteran.
Yeah.
But these guys tailgated way better than I ever could. And then, like, afterwards, the game's over. Like, Sweet Caroline comes on. Bah, bah, bah. So much fun. Crazy environment. Penn State wins. An amazing game. I got to be honest with you, okay? I bought a tail. I had a long tail. I was going to bring it. I forgot it. I hated Penn State my whole life. You just, when you're from Pittsburgh, you don't like Penn State. Because, number one, you're not smart enough to get into the school. Number two, Pitt is kind of your team, right?
Yeah, if you're going to go for a college team, you go Pitt.
You go right there. And then Penn State's just kind of like a cult after everything that happened.
And there were a cult before.
Right.
How that shit happened too, obviously.
And I just was like, I'm just going to go for the experience. You know what I mean? But I will wear white because I'm not there to start trouble. I got to tell you something, Dustin. I am a bigger Penn State fan than I'm a Pittsburgh Steelers fan now.
Oh, my God.
I'm telling you. Like, I fell in love with everybody there.
You're just drinking the juice, man. You're full in.
Listen, I understand how cults happen after going to a Penn State game. I mean, all it was, hey, have a mini beer. And I'm like, yeah, all right. Like, hey, have a Washington apple. Hey, all right. Hey, we need your blood. I'm like, here it is. It's AB positive. Here you go. I love Penn State, man. It was so much fun. And they're like, you can come back anytime you want. And I literally said, do not tell me that. Because I'm going to give up my Steelers season tickets. Because I couldn't do back-to-back ever again.
So, right, because you went to the Steeler game.
The next day. Well, listen to this, too. This was really funny. This is when I was like, oh, we're still... This is the time that I remember that we're in the middle of Pennsylvania. Because you got to remember, Penn State, you got to be kind of smart to get in there, right?
Mm-hmm.
Pretty smart. They were like, all right, fans, just remember, next Thursday, we're going to be doing open vaccinations here at Beaver State. Everyone goes... Boo! I was like, what? What are you booing?
Everyone's like, fuck that. We're alphas. We're major alphas. We can take it.
110,000 people. The biggest crowd I've ever seen in my life. They're like, no, we don't need that.
We don't need it.
Well,
we're good.
I just sat there. I was like, what? So yeah, and then you leave here. If you're from Pittsburgh, you've never been to a Penn State game. Here's how I describe leaving. Right, first of all, the whole city smells like shit because it's like a pasture town.
Mm, okay.
It's literally
surrounded by farms.
I could not smell it during the daytime. In the stadium, it smelled like asshole, like legit shit, like shit. And I didn't know you couldn't drink in the stadium.
You can't drink at the stadium?
Can't drink at the stadium. I don't understand why.
Is it like a recent thing? I don't even know.
I think because students, they just never approved it. Because slowly schools are approving it.
Okay.
And they haven't done it yet.
I feel like I've drank in a college, but now I don't remember.
Not that one.
Yeah, not that one at least.
So, and then I'm like, well, I'm hungry. I got to eat. You know what I mean? Like, I'm glad I'm not drinking because I got to drive home anyways. So I haven't drank since like 6 o'clock because I knew that the lines were going to be bad to get into the stadium. So I don't drink. Halftime comes and I'm like, well, they probably have good vending. It was like a high school, like a single A high school football game vending. The worm meat hot dogs, like burger patties that had dots on them,
yeah.
Like fake Burger King grill marks.
The total, like someone's just better with
like
ink.
Hollywood Hogan airbrushing this, like stripes on it. They didn't even have Heinz ketchup. It was like Fines. It was terrible. And I just remember, and I got so much food and I went with my friend Jenna and Jenna looked at me as I was eating it. And she goes, you look so disgusted right now. I was like, this is the worst fucking food I've ever eaten in my life.
And just, but still at the same time.
But you have to, you gotta
hydrate and replenish.
So game's over like 11 o'clock, an amazing atmosphere, so much fun. Everybody sings. It's like a soccer game. Like they all know when to do everything. It was crazy.
It's cold.
It game's over, right? Game's over. I'm like, all right, we'll get to my car. I haven't drank in 6 hours. I'm sober. This is great. Game 11 o'clock. It's a 2.5 hour drive. I'll get home in 2 hours. I'll be home by like 1 o'clock. Nope. You cannot leave the way that it's designed.
Oh.
You can't leave. I was there for 2.5 hours.
Like in your car, just trying just to get standing, out.
There are people here. They know this, and they were laughing at me when I thought we were going to leave. They're like, oh no! They fired up the grill, started cooking, started tailgating again to leave because they had enough time. These people next to us had enough time to sober up after drinking again because they knew they weren't going anywhere.
You're just the way the logistics and the roads are. You're just stuck until everyone kind of filters out.
So I don't get home till 4 o'clock in the morning. And I'm going to a Steelers game. I'm going to a Steelers
game.
Got to
go to work, man.
Steelers home opener. I can't call off. You know what I mean?
Yeah. You can't be calling off.
I don't call off.
Team needs you.
Yeah. So I, you know, I go to the game. I go with Rachel. I meet her at like 9:45. We're waiting for our Uber. And we just both looked at each other because like this is early for both of us to do anything. And I just go... Do we want to do this? She's like, you just want to watch it on the couch? And I was like, yeah. I was like, I really want to, but I can't miss it. You know what I mean? Like, you just can't miss it.
So home opener from a year and such.
Listen, the first time I heard the beer, the Icy Light Mango crack open, I was like, I'm good. I went right back to work.
That's what you said, like two beers and a song and like, oh, they're never losing.
It's third down. So I go to the game. I'm not really drunk at this point. I just feel good. Mm-hmm. I go to the game. It is a horrible game. Steelers played terrible.
Yeah, I'm not
Ben faked another injury because he played bad. That's what he does. And I don't even want to talk about the Steelers because, like, it's whatever. Mm-hmm. They lose. But you know what was so weird? I had such a good time at the game just hanging out. And I had such a good time the day before. I didn't care that they lost. And that's the first time that I can be honest with you.
I'm such a real moment right now.
In the 25 years that I've been going to Steeler games, because I went to my first one AFC championship game against Denver that we lost. But I've been going for 25 years. And I usually am miserable or I cry. I didn't give a shit. And I was sober. I did not care.
Now, if you were not sober, do you think it would have been a different...
No, that's my point, though. I think if I was drunk, I wouldn't have cared even more.
Yeah.
Honestly, I would have been like, oh, let's go to the bar.
So, I feel that way now a little bit more the games. Yeah. I think it was... I mean, I was prepared for this season of, like, not having high hopes. It was nice to win last week, but it wasn't like, oh, this week they're going to come out and fucking throw 35.
So.
You did. Of course you did.
I thought so. I
35
thought,
points.
I was like, we're never giving up a first down. We're just gonna win every game.
Yeah.
So I just hit a point and I just was like, this really doesn't matter.
Ooh, it seems like you're growing up.
I don't want to though.
Nah.
So then I was like, well, let's go to the bar, right? So then we go to Tequila Cowboy. We're there for a little bit, and it's just like Tequila Cowboy is very young. It's the youngest bar, I think, in North Shore. Where I still don't fit in. They're playing Achy Breaky Heart or whatever new country song is going on. And I'm trying to watch football. I'm like, I got to get out of here. I go to McFadden's. There's two people literally fighting right in front, like fist fighting right in front of us. And I'm just laughing. I'm just like, I hope they both just break their necks right now. Like, what is the point of fighting at a bar? It's so stupid.
I know. It is.
It's just stupid as shit.
Some people love it. That's what they come out to do. They just want to get riled up and start fights.
Like, we get it. You have a bad relationship with your parents. You know what I mean? You don't have to fight. Dad's not coming home. Yeah. Like, relax. He's gone. You know, and then I ended up going to the best, worst bar in the world, Lefty's.
Mm, yep.
And then I don't remember. That was it.
So you did black out at one point then?
I blacked out, but I knew I was blacking out.
Like you said before.
Yeah.
It's that controlled blackout.
Both times.
It's like you're setting up the substitute teacher, like, okay, listen, I need you to get him home.
Yeah.
All right. Like, no more shots.
Yeah. Saturday and Sunday was responsible blackouts.
That sounds like your new comedy album, Responsible Blackouts.
I like it.
Yeah.
I blacked out at a whiteout. It was pretty cool.
You blacked out at a whiteout.
But it was real. It was good. I mean, honestly, the best part of the Steelers game is there was a guy who shit his pants at the game. Here's what's fucked up about this. I didn't know about this at the Steelers game. I'm at McFadden's, you know, and I'm getting DMs from everybody going, did you shit your pants at the Steelers game.
Is it just automatic anything viral Steelers fans? It's just always Matt Light. It doesn't matter who it is now.
Like, I got friends that, do you remember Sarah Kanishi?
I don't fucking know.
Annie's friend, the Asian one. Oh, you're dropping. One.
Yes, yes. Okay, yes, I do.
She lives in New York. She messaged me. She goes, is that you? She doesn't even watch football. She just sees that some dude shit his pants, and it happened to be a Steelers fan. And when you think of shit and the Steelers, you think of me.
Think of Matt Light.
So I was like, no, I didn't poop myself. Also, this guy's tall.
Yeah. And there's like very small ass. He just had the littlest little baby ass.
And we're not going to show the picture because I don't think you can legally take a picture of a guy pantsless washing his pants in a bathroom.
Okay, so here's a question. If you walked in on this guy, would have you took that picture?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
But I only would have put it on Snapchat.
No, okay. Oh, all right.
You know what I mean? Like, I wouldn't put it, like, publicly
Not
everywhere.
Not that it would matter. I think if that was a Snapchat thing, someone was screenshotting that, and it was going. No.
I mean, I used to, I you know, my buddy Ray, we used to get really drunk. He was in the bathroom pooping one time at a Steelers game, which is probably the most, I'd rather shit my pants than actually poop at a Steelers game.
This guy's
game.
Probably had the right idea.
I remember him pooping at a Steelers game. It was Christmas Day because Ray still had a Santa hat on, and I peek over the thing and I start filming him while he's wiping his ass. And I'm like, here we go, Steelers. Hey, dude, he's not even mad. He just looks up at me. He's like, ha, 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 ha.
I'd be so scared, like, because someone's going to come in and mess with me. Either as a joke or just because they're drunk and in a hurry. No, I
just
don't.
It's just messy, dude. There's piss all over the floor.
It's not good.
And I'm worried that whatever pants I'm... are
going
to touch the cement pee.
But yeah. How many places have you seen troughs? I distinctly remember Three Rivers and the fucking long-ass trough to piss in. And I thought that was the craziest
thing. I love those.
Like how you like literally like had to go like... Almost right. Sideways to piss.
Can I ask you a question?
Go ahead.
Do you look?
No, not particularly, no.
No, I do.
You do?
I do if I think I can get away with it.
Like, I could say, like, maybe I accidentally look.
If I, like,
reach over
for a beer and go, let's see that, fuck.
Like, let's see that hog.
I'm just curious. It's not, you're not gay. You just... No.
But, like, often, like, I remember the situations. Most guys are drunk and they're coming in. They're trying to be funny. And it's like, all right, guys, what you got? Like, we got a 4. We got a 5. All right. 6+ over there. High five, bro. High five. All right. No? Wash your hands.
Yeah. I look. I won't ask him about it. Like, I won't be like, hey, dude, that's nice. What do you feed it? Like, you just appreciate
it. So, has anything ever blown you away either way? Like, have you been like, wow, I guess I'm doing okay.
I will tell you, pound for pound, soft.
Yeah.
I'm embarrassing. But I don't get it, though, because I'm not like, you know, I'm not.
You're a shower. You're a shower, not a grower. A grower.
I mean,
a shower.
I look at some of these dudes and I'm just grower, like, you got a lot of girth for being soft. Soft girth. I didn't know that was a thing.
Soft girth.
Soft girth.
Album two.
How do you like your
way.
Ice cream? Soft girth? Can I have the soft girth? Yeah, I didn't know that was a thing. Like, everybody has dad dicks, and I guess I just...
Everyone's got a dad dick. Well, it was a long time ago for the trough, maybe at the time.
Or yeah.
This is more recent.
Doesn't matter.
You're still doing this.
Doesn't matter.
You did this this weekend,
the point
didn't you?
Is... No, they were Raiders fans. I knew they didn't have a dick. I was like, why are you not sitting at this thing? I always hate that when they try and have a conversation with you. Like, hey, good luck. I'm like, at what, peeing or the game? Like, what are you... Just leave me alone.
I think it's like the nervousness thing. It's like the same thing. People can't pee with people around them. There's other people that, like, they need to be like,
oh, I'm
this
never
is normal.
Nervous.
What's up, man? How you doing?
Yeah.
You know, well, say something. Bite my ear.
You know, it's always awkward, too, like when somebody shakes your hand and, like, clearly, you know, they just got out of the bathroom and they washed their hands and they have to be, oh, I just washed my hands. Yeah, I know, because nobody just intentionally pisses all over their knuckles. Like, you don't have to tell me that. Like, oh, I just washed my hands.
They want to shake your hand so bad, but they know it's wet. But there's this, like, I still have
but
to
But I'm not
going to
be
you.
Like this and be like, what the fuck is this? What kind of liquid would be on your hands that smells antibacterial? You know?
Oh, that's true. I guess people are just assuming, like, it's water, bro. But maybe,
I like how we have to remind people to wash our hands now.
Yeah.
Because of COVID. Like, you guys just, you didn't do it before. Now you wash your hands?
Do you think you wash your hands more than you used to?
No. Less.
I think I'm, you were going the opposite way.
I already had COVID, and I have the vaccine. Now I'm just,
you don't care anymore.
Now I'm like, nah.
Throwing in the mud out there.
My balls.
Touch my balls first and then get a whiff of that and then shake the hand.
Yeah.
That's how we do it.
There's a lot of things that we do. You know, not only do we do this podcast, Dustin, but we do this on Patreon.
Uh-huh.
You know why Patriot? We do that?
Patriots?
The New England Patriots?
The New England Patriots.
Because, yeah, I don't know if you know this about our podcast, but the Matt Light Podcast is part of the Pits.com company, and you can watch more videos and you can see more behind the scenes podcasts at www.pits.company. And you can rate, review us on Apple, on Spotify, Google, YouTube, Facebook, share the stuff, like our stuff, comment, subscribe, do everything you can so that we can get numbers, so that we can get sponsors, so that we can get money, so that I can try less and less and less hard to entertain you guys because you already support me.
Content, content, content. You stole my thunder. That's all my reading.
No, I still have two more paragraphs.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Keep going.
All right. Our production services are provided by thegateway.media. Go to www.thegateway.media for all your production, video production needs. Thegateway.media. What can we make for you?
Oh, that was a legit. Like Reed.
Oh, we have a new sponsor.
Oh, yes, I got sponsors in there.
The Matt Light podcast is also brought to you by D's Nuts. D's Nuts, a great meme place mark for a sponsor. Anything else that I have to say?
Those are really just for me to say, but it was so great that you said them.
It was fun to do it.
And that was fun. And now you know how you will use that.
I know.
So that was great. Thank you, Matthew.
Hey, don't fucking call me that.
Ever since you started a podcast, yes, the last week, and I said Matthew, and now it's stuck in my head.
Did you see me stare at you?
Full name. Yeah.
I don't like that at all. If you, it's like, you know, if you don't, if I've never introduced, a name is what you're supposed to call somebody, right? If I give you a name to call me, that's what you're supposed to call me. You don't get to pick other shit, right? Like my mom and dad are like Matt, right? When I write my name, Matt, when you look at the graphic right fucking here, it says Matt. Why would you say Matthew?
What does your ID say?
Fuck you is what it says.
I'm pretty sure.
It says fuck you is what it says. My ID says I'm 32 years old. I'm an adult. I can pick my own fucking name. And it's Matthew.
Mm-hmm. And no what's, more your, what's your pronouns?
Shit. Poop guy. Poop guy, Steeler boy.
Poops McGee.
Yeah.
speaking of nothing, we talked about Nicki Minaj last week.
Oh, boy.
And you kind of threw your 2 cents. And then literally the next day, it went from like national news to world news. Like,
what happened?
Crazy. Well, apparently she got invited to the White House.
Why?
Because they wanted to talk to her. You know, they bring her on, be like, hey, let's talk to some doctors and stuff like that. And then she shared a Fox News clip. And then they basically like acted like she wasn't invited anymore. And then she got blocked on Twitter by the Twitter people. And now it's global news because she was like, I'm Nicki and I need to have my thoughts.
So
that's my impression of Nicki.
So wait a minute, you're telling me that they debunked Nicki Minaj's story that her cousins, nephews, uncles, dogs, groomers, pets, chinchilla don't have swollen balls from a vaccine tested by doctors, which is FDA approved.
But they had to do all that. They had to do all that to like. And then, like,
but all that's gonna do is make people be like, that keeps censoring us.
They took her germs. They did take her Twitter down, and it was like, come on.
Good.
Like, that's like, I might as well start going through the like I said before, go to the shopping market, medical advice magazines.
If you need medical advice by a fucking idiot whose ass is made out of plastic. Tits are made out of plastic. Nothing about her body is organic. and she's going to tell you, don't put the vaccine in your body when she has, what is in her ass right now?
I don't know. But the funny part is not so much, okay, whatever. Like, I didn't think, like, yeah, she's just spouting off craziness, but then, like, the effect of, like, oh, we're going to bring her to the White House. And then, no, the minister, the health minister of what was the country? I can't forget where it was.
Zimbabwe.
Was it Zimbabwe?
Nope.
It
was Afghanistan.
Guess again. No. But the
Trinidad.
It was Trinidad. The health minister had to make a public statement saying that, like, yeah, that's Trinidad. What it looks like. It's Trinidad. Had to make a public statement saying there's no record of, like, this even happening.
Why are the shittiest countries in the world the most beautiful countries in the world?
I don't know. I think you're just trying to live the country through Google, and it's probably not the same as going there.
But, like, you see the photos. Like, Mexico sucks, right?
Does it? I've seen nice pictures of Mexico. Yeah.
But it sucks.
Yeah, there's a lot of...
You know what I mean?
A lot of crime.
Bahamas, I'm sure that's not the best place to live. I don't think any of these places are great to live, but they just look nice.
Well, the places that are locked down by the Americans with the American hotels are nice. But you can't leave, like... I heard people telling me stories of, like, they go to Mexico, but they go to, like, the American-owned hotel, and they can't, like, walk. They're like, don't – you can come to Mexico, but don't literally leave this block.
I don't know. After watching everything in the news, I'm not really worried about other people. It looks like my boyfriend will fucking kill me, so.
Are you even a camper? Do you that kind of stuff?
Why would you go on vacation to live worse than you currently do?
I think it's when you have, like, lots of money and you're just so bored of your life in your living room on your TV and you just
then you just murder your girlfriend?
Yeah.
I'm fucking bored. I'm just gonna kill her. Yeah. I'm gonna come back and then disappear.
Yeah. Actually, I'm gonna hang out for a few days.
You know, I'm sick of the media saying he's missing. He's not fucking missing. He didn't just disappear. He's not a victim, okay? Allegedly, here's exactly what happened.
Allegedly.
I've read three sentences on this whole story, but I watched the first 48, so I know exactly what happened. Are you ready?
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Here it is.
The guy's abusive. He's been abusive for a while, okay? They go on this fucking vacation. He comes back with just her. And they're like, hey, what's the girl's name?
I don't even remember.
We're calling her.
White blonde girl.
White, that's the only reason why it's on the news.
Yeah.
Media distraction. Where's your girlfriend? Who? Oh, you know what? We were camping and she was playing. She was juggling with mountain lions. And then I don't know what happened. And the parents are like, you killed her, right? And he's like, fuck. Yeah. And they're like, all right, lawyer up, right? So he lawyered up.
Mm-hmm.
Talked to his lawyer for like 5 seconds. And this guy goes, yeah, you're guilty. Like, I'm not even going to represent you. You're 100% guilty. Now this dude's like, fuck, what am I going to do? His family comes from money. They have money.
Mm-hmm.
So he's slipping slides out the back. And he's doing one of two things. The first thing he's going to do, he's going for a Hail Mary. He's going to try to go to Mexico. He's going to try to go to Trinidad and find Nicki Minaj's uncle's balls, hang out with Super Bass Guy. And if that doesn't work, then he blows his fucking brains out.
Yeah.
That's what he's not missing, though.
Yeah. He's basically holding out on trying to, how am I going to kill myself?
Stop looking for missing men. Stop. It's not worth it.
Well, we got to find him. He killed this girl.
If a guy is missing, it's for a reason. Either he doesn't want to come back, or he's dead.
But he's wanted for murder now. I think we gotta go get him.
Well, yeah. Him different. Yeah. Just in general.
Okay, you're jumping to like two subjects there.
I'm just saying, he's not missing.
No, right.
He's on the run.
Yes, exactly. He's
not
missing.
But if somebody's missing, he's dead.
That is, you know what,
or
you're
he
right.
Left.
You're right. Like, it's the whole time when they actually knew where he was, like, why, like, it was like, why is he not being arrested? Why is he not being hailed somewhere?
Right.
And then he's gone. They're like, missing? I don't know. We don't know where he went.
No,
he
the reason
missing.
Why they made missing, the reason missing. Why they said missing for clickbait, mm-hmm. for you to click on the thing, oh, my God, the cartel got him, too? Oh, my God, who were they associated with? Nah, motherfucker, he killed him. He killed her, and she's gone.
Yeah.
He's hide and go seek. or he blew his brains out. I hope he killed himself.
Yeah.
It's well, I don't because way. I want him to suffer in jail.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? But you got he's got money. He might get the fuck away with this.
That's the weird. Have you seen pictures of him too? He looks like white trash in a lot of these pictures. And
yeah,
like I don't quite get. You're right. They come.
It's because it's not his money though.
Yeah,
it's not his money.
It's not his money.
You know what I mean?
It's a sad story, but it's like everyone likes to sleuth it. I mean, that's the entire internet right now.
Yeah, but this happens every day.
Yeah, but this one in particular, like Twitter was. It was like all of Twitter, like
but
taking
why?
Pictures.
But why?
Because
she's white?
Well, they even found out like some clues because another vlogger, like a YouTube vlogger.
Oh, so it's fun.
Exactly.
It's fun.
It's fun for these people. Not necessarily everyone, but
murder
like,
mysteries like made this shit fun.
Yeah, it's at that that first podcast Serial where everyone was like trying to solve the mystery. Now everyone all the time's like, ooh, Gabby, that's her name. They gotta like, let's find the picture on like that episode of South Park.
So that's what's scary.
Back
though.
To South Park again, where I know. Like they pretend.
But this is what's scary though. It's cause the internet is gonna influence more of this. There's going to be an internet clue murderer, I feel like, where he's going to, you know, remember when all those guys would leave notes and mm-hmm. they would get off by this? Mm-hmm. There's got to be somebody that has social media that is just thinking, okay, I'm going to plant clues on social media.
The Riddler is going to be like a real supervillain.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
It is. And he's going to hide all these hashtags and it's going to be a game and people are going to actually play that game.
And there's going to be so many. But here's the thing. As we're sick fucks, we're going to love it because we just want to get off from it. We're like, if someone's going to die, someone's going to die. But what if we win? What if we find them?
Yeah. And then there'll be like bets and stuff, just like, you know, watching these people.
This is going to open the floodgates. This is bad.
What is the actor from Harry Potter? What's his name?
Daniel Radcliffe. What about him?
There's a movie literally like we're talking about. It's not called Skrillex. But it's
no, that's a DJ.
To, yeah, I know. I can't remember what the hell that movie's called. But basically, you're like in a video game sort of thing. It's a real life thing. They kidnap you and they hooked all these things to you, and then you're part of this reality show that you watch,
mm-hmm.
and they're like forced to kill people and stuff like that, and then people can gamble and stuff like that. It's actually a really funny.
That's
movie.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Any other stories?
No.
You have another story.
Oh, another story. I thought you meant for me in particular.
No. We don't care about you.
We're full of like really fun, you know, news. A lot of good
upbeat news.
Yeah, upbeat news.
What's the new one?
So here's one. An Ohio mayor on Monday, he was up against a school board over sexual inappropriate writing prompts students were given in class. So the mayor was pissed because this teacher was giving prompts to these students. So I guess they're earning college credit, but they were high school students.
What was he having them do?
Do you want me to read a couple of them for you? How about I read a couple of these for you, and then you can tell me what you would write. So here,
okay.
All right, so here's one off the top of the bat. Choose how you will die.
What's wrong with that?
I don't know, that's asking a student, but you would write about that. So if you chose how you would die, what would you write?
Suicide.
That's it, you're just big. Okay.
Steelers lose the Super Bowl, I blow my brains out.
All right, here, real quick then. Here's another one. Write a sex scene you wouldn't show your mom.
Okay. That's enough.
Oh, come on. Well, you're not playing the game. You're not one of this.
This is for high school students.
This was for high school students. Write an X-rated Disney scenario.
That's fine. Yeah, like we could talk about that. You know what I mean?
Describe a time when you wanted to orgasm but couldn't.
All right, I think this guy just wants to jerk off aggressively at his students.
There's like 25 of these.
This is wait, what was the, these are legit ones?
These are real.
So what was it?
The last one?
Yeah.
I don't remember what I said. Describe a time when you wanted to orgasm but couldn't. These are like 17, 18 year olds, but you were in high school, right?
Why does this guy want to know this shit?
The weird part is
I get you're opening up your creativity, but why is everything an Amber Alert coming out of his fucking mouth?
Here's a weird one. If you're a serial killer, what TV shows are on your DVR list and why?
Well, I mean, I think that's an obvious one. Dexter's got to be number one.
But the mindset he gives you, it's like, you're a serial killer. You're a rapist and answer this question. And then he goes home and reads these
he
has.
But rape is a very, that's worse
mm-hmm.
than murder as far as, because there's PTSD involved. If you're murdered, you're dead. The serial killer question, I don't mind. Because we, as we just talked about this, everybody has this fixation already on this. Murder mysteries are huge. If you're a serial killer, clearly they're going to be talking about some sort of murders and what influences you, Ted Bundy, Netflix specials, things like that. That's things we already talk about. But the other stuff is really opening up the floodgates of very uncomfortable talk. Right? Like where this guy just literally wants details into who you are.
Exactly. He's just he's gross. At home just like reading stuff. You gotta think he has 20 some students at least. I'm just taking a wild guess.
And you know, he only wants answers from I feel like he's writing these questions for like certain people. Like the hot girls in school. He's I want to read hers.
Yeah, like one of these the questions he's not even caring about. He just goes right to Rachel's. Yeah. He's like, all right, I got you now, Rachel.
Yeah. Why'd you use that name?
She is into this stuff, you know, or
whatever. And they're like, Ethan, you've been homeschooled since you were 16 and a half. And all of a sudden you just showed up to school and you wear the same yellow polo. If you were a serial killer, what room would you shoot up in the school first? like there's a motive to what this guy is doing.
That one's a little bit better.
There's a method to his madness. Oh, man. If you were to shoot up a school, which teacher would you kill first?
Here's your favorite teacher.
Yeah. P.S. If it's not me, bonus points. Yes.
But the balls this guy has.
What would you do? What would you do if you were in school?
What if I got these questions?
If you were in school, no. And there was a nerd kid that got picked on, maybe. And that day, he said to you, "Hey, man, I wouldn't come into school tomorrow if I were you."
I remember. I mean, I was in school during Columbine. And I think anyone that would say, I would literally laugh off. I would not even.
No, but you were nice to this kid. You can see he was being picked on.
Yeah.
No.
I'd come. You think you wouldn't come in? Is that what you're saying? I'd come in. I wouldn't think people would do it. I would, especially when I was younger and in that mindset.
I mean, you like school? No way. You like school that much? You would go to school?
I just would not think like thing. I'd be thinking no one else is going to have the guts to actually do
but
that.
But like I'm saying now, because it's like a holiday for Americans. Like, it's September 21st. Somebody in Albuquerque, New Mexico is going to shoot up a school. Like, my point is, because it happens so often now, if you were a student right now, knowing what the culture is like, and some dude comes up to you and is like, "Hey, man, thank you. Don't come to school tomorrow." You know what I mean? Thanks for sticking up for me.
Yeah.
Don't come to school tomorrow.
Yeah, okay. Maybe now.
What would you do?
I probably wouldn't go to school.
Would you tell?
I mean, there would be so many, I don't know. I think at that age, like I could see what you're saying now. I would be like a different mentality. Because
I kind of almost feel bad for the kid. Yeah. Plus, I'm like, I don't want to rat on him.
You want a tattletale.
Right? Maybe maybe these dickheads deserve it for being so mean to him. Mm-hmm. The problem is, it's not those dickhead kids. They spray a lot of people to get to those dickhead kids. Or if you're in the way trying to stop them. I would not go to school. I would tell, but I'd be like, "Hey man, like do it the traditional white kid way." And the police would be like, "What do you mean?" I'm like, "Well, you got to stop at Burger King after you arrest them. You got to at least give them a meal after you apprehend them. Like this guy saved my life. You could call him a murderer. He didn't murder anybody yet, but he did save my life because he was going to kill everybody there. So get him a chicken sandwich."
Why do they do that stuff? What kind of mindset are you in?
Because what they do is they want to get you comfortable so that they have every piece of evidence against
you. Yeah, I guess that's true. It didn't come off that way from the news outlets.
Well, no, but that's what they do. Watch First 48.
Yeah,
you want a cigarette? Have a smoke. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, that chick, she was a fucking bitch. I'd have killed her too.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? Right. I don't blame you, man. And he's like, "Really? Yeah, did you kill her?" "Yeah." "You're a fucking idiot." "Well, you're gone."
Yeah.
"By the way, give us the rest of that cigarette and then just put it out on your forehead." You know what I mean? Once they get what they want, there's a motive to all of it.
That's crazy.
Scary.
Well, I shouldn't be killing anyone any soon then. Do you plan on that?
Could you kill somebody?
Would I kill somebody?
Could you?
I don't think so. I don't know. Like to protect myself, maybe.
If you were to kill somebody you did not like, how would you do it?
Oh my God.
Weapon wise.
Are you starting to ask me all these questions now too?
I'm just curious. What weapon would you use?
A gun.
Why?
Because it's the easiest and
pussy.
What? Are you a knife guy? Are you gonna
bat.
Oh my God.
I wanna feel it.
Oh my God.
I wanna feel the impact. You know what I'm saying? I want to know that,
you're
like,
fucked up,
I got a fucking base hit. Like, base is loaded and just blast them. I can't shoot. First of all, I don't like blood. But then again, if I hit with a bat, there's got to be spatter there, right?
Yeah. But you want that power.
I want the impact.
You want
that feeling
of, like, you got to,
you
like,
know, when you got a hold of one,
you do it.
When you play baseball, you get a hold of one and you know you got all of it and it's gone. I want to know that, like, I took the life out of you.
Jesus Christ. This podcast went.
Is that bad?
No, but I mean, it's not good, obviously.
It's not good. It's not good, but I'm just saying, like, if I'm going to kill somebody, it's because I don't like them.
What is that movie with the guy from Batman?
Toy Story.
I'm so bad with names off the top of my head. The good Batman.
American Psycho?
American Psycho. When he's
That's not the good Batman. Christian Bale.
You don't think Christian Bale's a good Batman?
No, you said the guy from Pittsburgh. That's Michael Keaton.
Oh, I actually met the movie. The Dark Knight was filmed in Pittsburgh. So.
Oh, yeah, it was terrible.
Mm, yeah. Wait, Dark Knight is the good one.
Yeah, Dark Knight Returns or something.
You're not nerd enough to respond.
The Last Knight.
Knight's Tale.
I was downtown.
Wait,
when they
Knight's
filmed
Tale.
It. They filmed it on my street.
Do you know the Knight's Tale has the Joker in it? That's Heath Ledger. Yeah,
so does The Cemetery now.
Anyways, I was just going to get to that point in that movie where he's like all smiles and he's like, hey, and just fucking chops the guy's head off after he like changes to like plastic.
Playing Huey Lewis. He's like, fun fact about this.
That's what he does.
Huey Lewis in the news.
Yeah.
And then it's.
Yeah.
I mean, I wouldn't go like that. I'm just saying that, like.
But the wind up, the feeling of like having to,
but
like.
Like in my head, I'm just like. Bum, 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 bum. Da-na-na-na-da-na.
Oh, man, this seems like a scene right out of the new Joker movie. Where, like, in your head, it's just so cool and fun.
I think I would be a great Joker.
Yeah?
I'm sick, fuck.
I think anyone that plays the Joker, like, you're not the same person afterwards. None of those guys, they're all crazy now. Well, if they were crazy beforehand.
Yeah, Jared Leto's a fucking weirdo now. Fucking, dude.
He runs his own cult. He actually has his own cult. Like, literally walks around like he's Jesus and stuff. I mean, it is pretty crazy. You're the Joker. You're in all these other movies. You're also in a band. You have a legit cult.
Any role, like, if you really get into it, you have to go crazy, right?
I guess.
Because you want to be that person. And people don't break character while they're filming. I think that's why doing comedies would be so easy for me, because it's just the kind of me anyways.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you can just be an exaggerated goofball, and it's not really about your performance on who the character is. It's more so what you can get out of the other people around
you. Right. It's kind of a Will Ferrell thing. He's similar.
He just wants to break you.
Yeah, but he's still the funniest. You know? So let's, speaking of future serial killers, here's your best friend, hanging out at the
AB.
No, I was gonna bring up AB, but we're gonna bring up another. This is Mahomes. Oh, right in front of you. That's Ravens game.
Yeah.
So apparently they were screaming and yelling at him. This guy's screaming, "Let's go, let's go!" And then TikTok Mahomes there just dumps water all over him.
Can you go back and play that again?
Yeah, hold on.
Could he pour the water any gayer?
He does. He, like, really, I think he doesn't want to, like, get in trouble, but he still wants to get him a little.
No, I mean, he's literally getting it all over him.
Yeah, but, like, you're right. He does do it real.
Gay.
Real.
Gay.
I'm trying not to say gay.
I will.
Yeah, you're saying it.
Look at it. I mean, excuse me. You're being nasty to me. You're being mean. Listen, I fucking hate him. I hate him, and I hate his future sister-in-law, because they put this all on themselves every time.
Mm-hmm.
He's obnoxious on TikTok. He talks shit to other people on TikTok. She's loud as fuck, talks shit to fans, and then when this happens, they play the victim.
Yeah.
If you can't dish it, if you can't, whatever the saying is, fuck you. The whole family.
Yeah, once, shame on me.
Yeah, fool me twice.
Fool me twice.
Not gonna fool me again.
Yeah, never gonna fool me again.
I can't handle it. Jackson Mahomes is so awkward to begin with. His TikTok videos cringe. And dude, to be honest with you, you know, I'm a Pittsburgh Steelers fan first and always. I wanted the Ravens to whoop their ass.
Yeah.
I hate the Chiefs. I fucking hate. They're so arrogant, dude. And listen, yeah, you won the Super Bowl 2 years ago. You didn't win it this year. Father Time whooped your ass. You know what I mean? Tom Brady beat the shit out of you. And I'm so sick of people bashing Lamar Jackson. He's awesome.
You were bashing him earlier.
It doesn't matter. He's a rival. Okay, if you're telling me right now I can have any quarterback in the NFL, I would probably take not him, but he'd be top five.
He's top five. Top five. It is ridiculous. Right? I mean, like, everyone.
Dude, he changes the game. You cannot prepare for somebody who runs a 4.2.
Nope.
Oh, we have a game plan for him. You're not fast enough.
And he's not sliding and shit either.
No. he stiff arms TJ Watt.
It was great. Oh,
he's
man.
A beast.
You know, and his throws aren't bad. I mean, he just makes bad. It's not like his throws are bad. He'll just make a
stupid
bad decision.
Fucking decision.
He just, like, all of a sudden just does. It's like he's playing Madden for real, though. It's like, he's down there somewhere.
Hey, it was Big Ben when Big Ben would extend the plays. Either he'd get sacked or he'd fucking throw up a shitty ball, or he eventually waited till AB got open.
Yeah.
But you live and die by what this guy does. Listen, he's great. I like Lamar Jackson, dude. I think he's a beast.
It is fun game to watch.
He's so fun to watch.
It's so much fun to watch because every play is like a possible, you know, run for 30
Anything
yards.
Can happen with
him. It's crazy.
Yeah.
Well, we're wrapping it up there, man. Unless you want to talk about the Emmys or something like that. Any more entertainment news?
I don't know anything about the Emmys.
You don't know anything about the Emmys?
Mm-mm.
Well, then we probably should wrap it
up. Well, hold on. Did you see Conan?
Oh, yeah. You did talk. You heard about Conan. He just ran up there, I guess.
Was there a reason behind any of this?
I have no idea.
So, like, I think, because Conan retired this year, right?
Right, right.
Okay, so.
Am I boring you?
Yeah. It was the opening monologue, and Conan came out. He was in the background, and they were kind of, like, softly cheering. And he's like, yeah, woo, saluting like John Cena, just like going nuts.
He's also like 6'3", you know, redhead. And he's this ginormous man back there.
And I don't think he's a big drinker. So I don't think he was even drunk. I don't think he was planted to do it either.
No, he
just said, fuck it. Fuck everyone here. And then Stephen Colbert was sitting next to him. And Stephen goes, hey, if we win, you want to come up with us? And Conan goes, I mean, yeah, I guess. And then he goes back up to Steve and goes, I mean, like, are you sure? If you don't want to, I will. Steve's like, we love you. Come on up here. And so I think they were just honoring him.
Yeah, I think because they know they're not going to get it. He's not going to get a reward, obviously, because he's not on TV and he got screwed over. What was that? 5-6 years ago.
So it was kind of his fuck you to everybody.
Yeah, it was like, hey, you want to go tell everyone to fuck off? You can come up and tell everyone to fuck off.
Yeah.
You know, he didn't say there. He smiles, but he's in the back of his head like, we know you're the best, Conan.
It's Conan
we
the know best
you're,
ever.
You're better than all these other idiots who basically stopped doing late night television 5 years ago. You know,
before we go, we lost somebody very, very important last week. Norm MacDonald, man. That was
sad.
That was a tough one. It's a tough one. Not even knowing that he had cancer.
I mean, I thought that was kind of cool, at least for him. I'm sure that was maybe difficult to do. But man, wouldn't that have sucked for everyone? Like we would have known. Then we would have to talk about it. Then he would have had questions about it.
Well, that's what brought me. That's what brought my mind to it is because, you know, when Conan had his last show, I was curious, why was Norm MacDonald one of your last guests? Because he's always had a very interesting interview with him. And he loves Norm. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So I was like, oh, this is weird that it was just like Jack Black and a couple other people. I was like, why would Norm not be on, you know, one of those weeks? So he wasn't doing well. My favorite Norm MacDonald moment of recently, it was like 2 years ago. He had a show on Netflix. Did you ever watch it?
Yeah, it's like kind of like a podcast show.
Right. He had David Spade on there.
Mm-hmm.
Did you ever see that episode?
Yes, I have seen that.
So anybody who hasn't seen it, I don't know if it's anywhere on there anymore, but so it's like a podcast show. It's really cool because it's they're just talking. They're just sharing stories. It's just buddies. And, you know, him and Spade are good friends. And David Spade gets into telling a 6-minute story, and he gets done finishing telling the 6-minute story, and Norm goes into his earpiece, and goes, "Oh, we didn't get any of that. We didn't film any of that. Hey, listen, you're gonna have to tell that story again." And Spade goes, "Okay, yeah, that's fine. I can do it again." So Norm acts like they're coming back from commercial. Mind you, this is a Netflix where there's no commercials, but like they're just filming again. Sets him up. Spade does the whole fucking 6 minute story again. And then all the producers and executives behind him start laughing. And he's like, were you filming the whole fucking time? Fuck you.
And the whole thing's in the show, right?
Yeah.
Like, I think I remember, like, I think Drew Barrymore was his first guest on that show.
Yeah.
And if I remember correctly, she kind of comes out and she's like, well, what are we doing? Like, oh, we're just talking, you know? Like, it wasn't a set up thing. And so I think even, you're right, even a few times maybe Drew's like, are we going to commercial? Or like, no, you just, I guess. What was some, yeah, sure, whatever, maybe,
he,
you know.
What I liked about him, man, is he, excuse me. I know, I'm yawning so hard.
Drinking before we
him,
do this.
Him and Tom Green were always big influences because like they didn't give a fuck.
Mm-hmm.
They just didn't care. They weren't afraid of being uncomfortable. You know, like if the joke doesn't land, you know, people are insecure. Like, yeah. I'm not going
to
tell
you
that.
You got to try to catch up.
Work.
Or then you try to catch up when the joke's bad. You try to fix it.
No, they just marinate in the awkwardness.
Yeah, just let it in there.
And
fine.
You talk about fearlessness. I mean, that guy did not give a fuck. And is absolutely fearless. And, you know, this is not a podcast where anybody famous will listen to. And it's, and you know, but I just wanted to bring it up because I don't post on social media when somebody dies because I don't know them personally. I'm not doing it for sympathy votes. You know what I mean? And I just, it was a tough loss though. I mean, it was one that like, I was like, cause you get a few celebrity deaths and you're like, fuck, mm-hmm. right? Like Robin Williams was a big one. Michael Jackson for me was a big one just because when I was a kid, you know, I used to listen to his shit. You probably thought I was going to go somewhere on that.
You're taking his shit. Yeah.
No, you know, Mac Miller was huge, Pittsburgh kid. You know what I mean? And this one, just because of what he did for comedy, man, he did so much. His roasts. Where like he wouldn't roast, but he would roast. He was great, man. So, you know, we're gonna fucking miss him.
The best thing I have to say I saw was just like they cut together all his OJ material from Weekend Update and
well,
other
dude, that
things.
Was a big reason why you're fired because he kept doing OJ jokes.
He wouldn't let go of the OJ joke. And then they showed him on The View doing it, and the women
oh my
are
God,
like
about
yelling at
about
him.
About when he said that the Clintons murder people.
Oh, it's so fun. And they get so upset. It was like, oh man, it's
he's like,
hilarious.
You can't talk about that. He goes, yes, I can.
Yes, I can.
Yes, I can. I just did.
He was great.
Yeah.
He was great. The GOAT.
He was great, man.
Well, it's nap time, I think, for both of us.
Yeah, I'm done, man. So thanks for everybody that listened. Keep in mind that if you want to see even more goodies, go to our Patreon page. Dustin, what is our Patreon page?
It's patreon.com/, which goes this, whoop, yeah, that way. Making sure because I'm mirrored. Oh, my goodness. Mm-hmm. / Matt Light Comedy.
Yeah, and it's only $5 a month, which is $1.25 an episode. If you don't think we're worth $1.25, we're going to kill ourselves. We're going to end up.
We talked about how we're going to do that earlier.
We're going to end up with Gabby's boyfriend, Brian. We're going to run away and blow our brains out. that's probably what's going to happen. So from the Gateway Media Studios, I am Dustin Dowling. And alongside me here is Matt Light. Everybody have a great night. Also, make sure to say your prayers and eat your hammers.